In front of 13,000 fans, the leading scorer in the Pac-12, Trey Holder, and the number 11 Sun Devils hosted the Oregon Ducks at Wells Fargo Arena Thursday evening. Early on, the task for ASU was to crack Oregon's zone defense. It didn't take long. With a little ball movement and nice passing, Mickey Mitchell found himself banging one home to give his team the early lead. But Oregon's Elijah Brown, who had 18 points on the night, responded with his own finish at the rim and cut the Ducks' deficit to just 2 points. It was Shannon Evans that ignited the 11-2 run for the Sun Devils when he started cooking from deep and made 2 of 4 of his three-pointers on the night in the first half. But good defense led to offense as the Ducks went on a run of their own, making things interesting, tying the game at 41-all heading into halftime.
We quick shot and allowed them to close the gap, which I thought hurt.
In the second half, the Sun Devils couldn't keep Oregon outside of the paint. The Ducks outscored ASU 18-6 in the second half alone.
Advantage in the paint, try and win the paint. You know, that was something that we talked about before the game. It was 38-16. You know, it was a big difference.
The glass, honestly, I think McIntosh had 5 or 6 offensive rebounds, and he finished with 13 rebounds. He was just all over the glass.
Although ASU was dominated on the glass in the second half, they took this game down to the wire. But it was late mistakes and late missed free throws that ultimately led to a 76-72 win for the Oregon Ducks.
You got to make free throws down the stretch to keep it close. You can't give up, you know, the offensive rebounds that we gave up. I thought that was a major deal. They did a nice job of tempoing the game and make it a real possession game. And, it was choppy again. We never really got into a great rhythm on offense.
The Sun Devils are going to have to shake this one off quickly as they welcome in Oregon State on Saturday for their second home game of conference play. This has been Chaz Frazier reporting, Cronkite Sports.